Our big campaign at the moment is a referendum that's coming up in October or November to repeal the clause in our constitution that makes blasphemy an offence. Now, it's an outrageous clause. It came in the 1930s when our constitution was written, along with other great clauses like the duties of women in the home, there's a clause that says that the state acknowledges that the homage of public worship is due to Almighty God, which, if you think about it for a second, is not even a clause enshrining the right of the people to worship God. It's a clause enshrining the right of the God to be worshipped, as if the creator of the universe, you know, depends on Amy De Valera for the rights to be upheld. So the blasphemy law, it's one of those things. I know you have a blasphemy law here, and I know a lot of countries have blasphemy laws that are kind of anachronistic blasphemy laws that the states, for whatever reason, haven't got round to getting rid of. But ours is different. We are the only country in the Western world that has passed a new blasphemy law in the 21st century. And one of the big dangerous things about that is, first of all, obviously it's silly, and we all know that, but it does have harmful effects. First of all, domestically, although it hasn't formally been enforced yet, although there was an investigation into Stephen Fry for an allegedly blasphemous comment on RTE a year ago, although it hasn't been formally enforced, we know that the media are choosing to self-censor themselves. Because most people, if you're running a radio station, you're running a newspaper, you're not interested in winning political arguments about whether the blasphemy law is enforceable or not. You just don't want to get involved in a blasphemy case. So they just won't touch issues just in case there's even any chance of it. So there's self-censorship involved, so it does have an impact. The other thing that's very dangerous about the blasphemy law is that Pakistan, the moment we passed our blasphemy law 10 years ago, Pakistan led the Islamic States of the United Nations in calling for the wording of the Irish law to be implemented internationally. And they used that to justify their own human rights violations in Pakistan and Islamic States, because they like to point to a Western state as an example of Western hypocrisy. Here is Ireland passing a blasphemy law just a few years ago. What's wrong with blasphemy laws? There's nothing wrong with blasphemy laws. We also have a minority Muslim group called the Ahmadi Muslims, who believe that there's another prophet after Muhammad, they're persecuted by the Sunnis and the Shias, and we work alongside them. They are campaigning with us to get rid of the blasphemy law. When Pakistan was being questioned last year on its human rights record, we brought over a delegation from Atheist Ireland and the Ahmadi Muslims of Ireland and the Evangelical Alliance of Ireland to speak up for Christians and atheists and Ahmadi Muslims and other minorities in Pakistan who couldn't speak out for themselves because they would be in danger of their life, but we went out to speak out on their behalf. And again, that had a very big impact psychologically. So it's really important that although the law is silly, it's also dangerous, it's really important that we do win this referendum. We should win it, but there's no point in being complacent. There is a number of dangers in terms of it, of the blasphemy law being presented as if it's about religious tolerance and respect and so on. So we really need to get the message across on that. Now, if there's anything, if any of you here have you know friends or relatives in the Republic that you're talking to, ask them to get involved in the campaign. If any of you want to come down yourselves when we're doing canvassing or something, we'll keep you in touch with what we're doing. We'd really welcome your support in this. It's going to coincide with the presidential election, which is likely to be in October or early November.